one of the most sophisticated apps I've ever come across. Absolutely mind-boggling how this app exists for free.
What's up everyone, welcome back to my channel, or if you're new to my channel, welcome. My name is Meghna. Today's video is actually a part 2 of a video that I did back in Vlogmas during my Vlogmas series. In that video, I shared some of my most favorite apps related to productivity and self-care, and that video received so much love from all of you, and I thought, you know, I have to do a second part because I have a new set of apps that I'm absolutely obsessed with. These apps that I'm going to share with you in this video are going to help you be more productive, manage your time better, even take care of your mental health. And another great thing is that all the apps are free and they're available both on iOS and Android. With all of that being said, I'm sure you guys are super excited and stoked to know what these apps are, so let's quickly get into it. The first one that I'm freaking obsessed with is called as Routinary. So you all know that I am
a completely routine person. I love setting new routines. I have so many routines on my channel. Night routine, evening routine, daily routine, morning routine, grooming routine, you name the routine, I've done it on my channel.
In fact, I have an entire playlist which is beside the point of this video, but I will anyways link it up in case you guys are interested in that. Anyways, talking about routines, the name is pretty self-explanatory. It literally helps you create your routine and stick to it. The interface is so friendly, like it's quite intuitive. You won't take a long time to figure out how this entire app works because there are apps like that. So when you click on the app, it's very minimalistic, just to the point. On top, there will always be a new quote coming, which just keeps you motivated and pumped. As you can see, I've already set my morning and night routine. You can set more routines, but then you have to pay for it. But for me, I'm pretty good with my morning and night routine, like the basic one. In the routine settings, you can name it whatever you want. What if you're not someone who wants to fix a morning routine, but you want to fix a study routine or a skincare routine? So you could just rename it and put your own emoji. You can also set the days that you would want to be following that routine. So if it's a particular skincare routine, you may not be doing it every single day. Maybe you're doing it alternate days. So like that, it's quite flexible. You can create it however you want. You can of course set your reminders. What time will the routine kick off? So I put it at 7:20 a.m. because that's when I wake up. And once you have the basic settings of the routine set, then you can go on this section and just add habits. They have given like a default set of habits that would be ideal for any morning routine. So that's drink water, make bed, and they have also given like a standard time that might be needed for that activity. For example, for drink water is 1 minute, because I mean, probably would not need more time than that. Making bed, weight check, meditation, the list is endless. But if you want to create your own habit, you can also do that. You can just click on new and you can change the icon, set the duration. So if you feel like making bed is going to take you more than 1 minute for whatever reason, then you can just change that time to whatever you want. And yeah, that's pretty much it, guys. This is like a rough look at my morning routine. I still haven't set it properly because I'm still figuring out my balance, but for now this is how it goes. So I brush teeth, do my skincare, make bed, study for 1 hour, then I'm changing clothes. So even for changing clothes, I've set some time aside because I do have to change from my ghar ke kapde to my workout clothes. Then 1 hour workout, then I have to shower for 15 minutes, so I have given buffer time. My breakfast does not take 30 minutes, but of course there are times when I'm just talking with my family, chilling here and there. I'm putting buffer times everywhere. Again, it's super flexible, very intuitive, very clean interface, which is the best part. We have set our routine, that's great. Now when you hit on start, it shows that my entire morning routine is for 4 hours and 7 minutes, which is a lot, guys, I know, but this is technically my morning to noon routine. It's not just my morning routine. It shows the total amount of time that you need for that routine. I'm gonna hit play and then the timer goes on. So it's like brushing teeth, I have 3 minutes set for it, that's it. In case I do finish it earlier, I can hit the next button and then it moves on to the next activity, which is skincare, so on and so forth. You can just keep doing this. I think this is the best part of this app, like there's a time running for your entire routine. You have to keep going and there's no stopping here, which is why I suggest that you do have buffer time so that it doesn't feel like you're literally just brushing and suddenly doing your skincare and running around to make your bed and then sitting here starting your studies or whatever that is. So it's good to have that sort of 1-2 minute, 5-10 minute ka buffer time, depending on how much time you do have in the morning. And every time you finish a routine successfully, you can level up. There's a fun table and chart and analytics through which you can see how often you followed a routine. Highly recommend this app. Now the second app is another very intuitive and super simple app, but so freaking useful, and that is called as Toggle or Toggle Track. So Toggle Track is essentially a timer app. Now I mainly use it on my computer. There's also a computer app for it, but you can use it on your phone depending on whatever you find more convenient. As long as you sign up with the same email, it is synced. So how many ever times I use Toggle on my computer, it is also synced on my mobile app, which is great. What this app essentially does is track your time. As simple as that. We don't realize that the most basic thing about time management is tracking your time. So all of us keep thinking about, okay, how can we manage our time better?
What routines can we set and keep our phones away and focus more on our work and studies? Like,
those are of course things that we need to think about, but the basic foundation of time management is to track your time. Again, the app is very simple. There's I'm working on, you click on that, and then you can add a project. Let's say I'm shooting this video, so now I can add it to a project. Let's say this project is productivity apps and the tag is YouTube because it is YouTube related work, and then you just hit that and the timer is ticking. Once the shoot is over, I will hit the stop button and then I will know I spent, of course it's 1 minute now because this is like a dummy test, but essentially I can see that it takes 1 hour for me. So next time I know that a sit down video like this would prox take 1 hour for me. And the more I figure out small things like this, like how much time does it take for me to study a certain chapter or finish doing a certain presentation, like all of those things I take account for. I only do it for my work because that's what I need to really focus on, dividing my time properly and spending focused hours on it. Instead of having 8 hours of shoot, I can just make it into 1 or 2 hours of shoot because there's a timer running and I'm completely focused on it. Now, the great thing about this app is that, at least on my computer, that's how it works. So I'm editing a video. The moment I lift my hand off the mouse, let's say I get distracted with my phone and just scrolling through social media, calling a friend, doing some other thing, I get a notification on my computer saying that I've spent 20 minutes idle time on Toggle. So should they delete that idle time and continue from where I left off, or should I keep the idle time? Because sometimes in case of me shooting right now, I'm not using the computer, right? So there's no mouse movement. So the notification can still pop up saying that, you know, there was 30 minutes of idle time where you did not do anything on the computer. Should they still include that in the timer or should they delete it? I will say keep the idle time because I was working. But when I'm editing on my computer or using my computer and working on my computer, every time that idle time thing comes off, I'm like, oh wow, I just wasted 15 minutes doing random things, drinking water, going outside, talking to my brother, playing with my cat. All those small things, they actually add up, take up a bit of time. So it could be 15 minutes, 10 minutes even, and that keeps adding on. And before you know it, you're editing for 8 hours instead of just editing for 2 or 3 hours of focused attention. This app has taught me so much about how focused attention can really change the game when it comes to time management. That timer running in the background really helps you and forces you to focus on the work at hand. Instead of spending 8 hours on editing, I just spend 4 hours now. I prefer the Mac version over my iOS, but both do the same thing, so it's just personal preference. But you guys have to try out Toggle and see for yourself how much time you're spending on random things and how fast can you get certain tasks done with the help of this Toggle timer. The next app is very, very, very interesting, and it's one of the most sophisticated apps I've ever come across for mental health, and it is absolutely mind-boggling how this app exists for free. The app that I'm talking about is called as Stoic. Now, Stoic is derived from Stoicism, which is a school of philosophy, quite popular, but I did not come across it until very recently. And this app sort of encapsulates all the principles of Stoicism. Now, every time you open the app, it will ask you how you are feeling. Again, the interface is very minimalistic, quite classy as well. So when you do this exercise in the morning, you will get this prompt: how did you sleep? What is your main focus? These are the three things. Now, what is the single most important thing you need to do today? And how motivated do you feel? What are your goals for today? Then they'll give you sort of like a snippet of one of their teachings. Every day it's something else. If you want, you can favorite this if it has really impacted you that much. And if there's some running thoughts in your head, you can even subcode this entire thing and just write your own thoughts about it. Now, I'll be honest, some of the things are things that I can't do every single day because it could get a little time consuming. But the great thing is you can still skip it. Like, if I don't want to write this, I can just skip it and just go on with the rest of the things. List three things you are grateful for. Again, a great gratitude exercise. Then they'll give you these three exercises that you can complete to kickstart your day. I freaking love this. So you can start journaling, just anything, again, free flowing. There's something called Awake as well, which is basically like a breathing exercise. So they literally guide you through it. You can also hit on meditation. They have background sounds of forest, raindrop, fire. Again, customizable the interval time, and you can begin your meditation. And after you finish meditation, you can also add a note of what you probably meditated on or anything that just suddenly came across your mind and you want to jot it down, you can do that. Apart from that daily morning routine and night routine journaling thing, they also have these exercises like I mentioned. So journaling, we saw already. Visualization. So this is negative visualization. I believe it's part of the Stoicism philosophy. It could be catharsis, right? It could be really helpful to someone who's actually going through something and you want to get out of it. Negative visualization is one of the tools that you could be using. And there's also something interesting suggesting called fear setting. You can name your fear. Let's say I'm scared to start a YouTube channel. That could be my fear. How afraid are you of taking this step? Let's say I am quite afraid. Now I have to list the potential worst case scenarios in my head that I've cooked up for myself. People would judge me, people judging me, disappointing myself, and so on and so forth. I'm sure there are many fears related to that. How can you prevent or minimize that possibility of people judging me? That's the situation I had put, so they've mentioned it here, or disappointing myself. Just really practical exercises that they help you with to tackle your fears, how you can repair it, what are the benefits of starting your YouTube channel in this case. I'm not going into it in depth because then this video will take forever. But yeah, there's just a lot to explore in this app. So to cut it short, this is like an all-in-one mental health, mental care, self-care app. Definitely give this a shot. It can seem a bit daunting when you just look at it from an outside perspective, but once you download it, it will guide you step by step with everything. Now, last but certainly not the least, we have perhaps the most complicated app, but it's changed my life, okay? And the app I'm talking about is called as Notion. I don't know how many of you would have heard of it. I don't think it's as popular in India as it is abroad, but I did come across it last year and I did try my hand on Notion. But let me tell you, the first 2 to 3 times I completely gave up because it is complicated. It has a learning curve and it'll take a lot of time and patience to understand the entire interface. So I still haven't learned all the ins and outs of Notion because, like I said, it's a very detailed, it's a very in-depth app that will take months and months to master. But I have found my own ways to make the most out of Notion for now and just get better at it with time. So Notion is an all-in-one workplace. It's a tool that helps you blend all your everyday apps into one place. I have spoken a lot about Asana on my channel and even Trello, especially Asana, because that's what I use to plan all my content for YouTube. Again, Notion is available both as a website, so you can use it on your computer or you can use it on your app. Both are equally good, but I just prefer using my computer because I'm always on my computer. It just looks much better on a bigger screen for me. So here's how my Notion looks. As you can tell, it's called Magic Shop, and for any BTS army out there, you know what this is. And for any non-fans, Magic Shop is one of their songs, and I really really love what the entire song is about. In fact, Magic Shop actually literally is inspired from a form of psychodrama therapy called as Magic Shop. Hello, welcome to the Magic Shop, please enjoy your stay. So I just created this really cute persona of my Notion hub. I've actually added the Magic Shop song also here. You can add your own widget. So imagine your own blog or website, but it's an app, you know, it's a tool. Basically super customizable. You can add whatever widgets you like on this. So I have a quote widget here which keeps refreshing every hour. Then I have the main essentials page here. So again, this won't be seen on your page if you're completely unaware of Notion. It'll literally be blank when you first go there, and then you have a lot of templates from which you can duplicate it into your own page and change the name, change it to however you like it. So this is again a template that I got from somewhere. And then I have certain sub pages or sub links. So study Korean. So when I click on study Korean, my study plan and the dates, tags under it, so grammar, revision, vocabulary, resources, which books I'm using for it. Another one is Gratitude Corner, which I haven't actively started using, but I recently found this template, which I really, really love. There's also a K-drama tracker that I have. The most important part for me is the Kanban board. And I'll go to my Q2 April so that you can see how my April Kanban board setup was. On the left hand side, I have the 3 goals. Right now, the not started one is empty because I have completed all of them. As you can see, it's a long list. I'm very, very happy about it. But on the rightmost side, there's also not done, some of the things that I could not get done. If you don't know about Kanban system, I do have a planning tools video that I shot during Vlogmas, which I will link up here. There are more resources that I'm talking about with regards to Kanban board. So I think that'll be really helpful if you want to know more about the Kanban system. But yeah, this is what I mainly use Notion for. Like I said, you can use Notion for anything and everything. If you want to store all your favorite recipes, you can do that on Notion. If you want to review books, you can do that on Notion. You can track habits on Notion. That's one more thing that I'm planning to start very soon. You will find all possible templates on the search option. So when you hit on search, you can type out whatever you want and you will most likely have templates already for that. But yeah, once you slowly get a hang of it, it will get much easier and you will not be able to get out of Notion. I know I did not explain a lot about Notion because it's impossible. Absolutely impossible to teach you how to use Notion in this one video, but I am planning on making a Notion video eventually, only once I am quite confident about how to use it myself. You guys should give it a shot. There are hundreds of Notion tutorials on YouTube. Learn it for yourself, see how it works out for you, and yeah, let's just get into this Notion gang together. So those were all the apps that I've been absolutely loving, and it's literally game changing for me. Let me know which app was your favorite, or have you used any of these apps? What do you think about them? I will link down all the apps, both iOS iOS and Android versions in the description box below, so make sure you check it out. And if you like such videos, make sure you do leave a thumbs up and also subscribe to my channel and click on the bell icon so that you don't miss out on any of my future videos. And if you like such content on productivity, I do have a channel membership for all my subscribers where there's a lot of extra exclusive content. So I do a monthly podcast, a monthly recommendation, I do a real-time study with me, there's weekly quotes, custom emojis, a lot of stuff happening on my membership as well. So if you're interested in checking out all the perks that I offer, I will link that as well in the description box, so make sure you check it out. And it's getting pretty hot because the fan is off and it's summer, and I just can't wait to tie my hair up in a bun and switch on the freaking fan. With that being said, I will see you all in my next video. Till then, stay happy, positive and blessed, and stay safe, guys. Bye.
And I think to myself, what a wonderful world.